All right, here we go. I'm gonna teach you all the things you need to know about solder paste. It's something that might seem kind of obvious, but stick with me here. It's gonna be useful, I promise.
Here's what it looks like.
So solder paste consists of two main components, flux and some kind of powdered metal. Our paste is actually three metals, tin, bismuth, and silver. But that's not super important for this video. Just keep in mind that traditional solders and hassle finish on prefab boards are likely to contain lead. Lead and bismuth don't like each other. Because of this, it's a good idea to stick with an appropriate paste for your application and clean your iron well if you're switching between standard wire and ours. Here's a cartridge of solder paste. And here's what it looks like under a microscope. It looks like a bunch of little balls, because it is. Those little balls can come in a bunch of different sizes. These sizes are measured from T1 to T8. This paste is a T4 paste, which means most of the little balls range from 20 to 38 microns. A T5 paste would range from 10 to 25 microns. It's important to know the size of the particles you're dispensing so you can be sure to pick the appropriate nozzle size. A very general rule of thumb is that you need an aperture 6 times larger than your particle to avoid clogging. This is why it's a bad idea to use 150 micron nozzles with T4 paste. All these little guys are suspended in flux. Flux does a couple of things. One is simply acting as a carrier for the metal, but it also protects the particles from oxidizing. Flux's main benefit, though, is the ability to help with the wetting process. Flux comes in a bunch of different varieties and activity levels. The one we stock is REL0 TAC Flux. We find a thicker flux will work better with the V1 printed boards. If your flux dries up or the paste separates, you're gonna go from solder paste to solder waste in no time. It's always a good idea to check your cartridge for any flux leakage around the piston. A little bit won't hurt, but if you see something like this, it's time to get a new cartridge. Additionally, you don't wanna leave your paste sitting super long before reflowing. An hour or two is okay, but I wouldn't push it beyond that. If you've got material that's not been used in a while or it's been sitting out too long, it's possible the paste in the nozzle will have dried out. Up close, good paste looks like this. Bad paste looks like this. You can see how the bad paste is all clumpy. This is gonna result in garbage dispensing and likely worse reflow. If you find that you can't get anything to come out of the nozzle, don't force it. Forcing a clogged nozzle is only gonna end in a ruptured cartridge. I know you're strong, you've got nothing to prove to me, just swap out that nozzle and get back to business. If you're finding the flow isn't smooth, then you probably just need to purge the nozzle. It's super straightforward. Just turn the gear and apply a bit of pressure on the paste. Let it flow until you notice a change in how smoothly it's coming out. If you check my other video here, you can see what to expect when reflowing our ink compared to reflowing with traditional boards. So I won't go into too much detail on that here. I will say though that if you're seeing something you didn't expect, don't freak out. Most of the time, everything is cool. And you can always hit me up on chat, I'll get it sorted for you.